Slava Isusu Christu. I'm standing in front of the church of one of the oldest Ukrainian Catholic parishes in North America, St. Cyril and Methodius in Oliphant, Pennsylvania.
Ukrainian Catholics in America did not always have a clergy to whom they could turn. Because the first groups of Ukrainian immigrants lacked their own priest, they often attended services in churches of other East European groups, particularly the Roman Catholic churches attended by Poles. In the 1880s, a group of Ukrainian Catholics in Shenandoah, Pennsylvania, brought the Ukrainian Church to America. They sent an appeal to the head of the Ukrainian Catholic Church in Galicia, Metropolitan Sylvester Semratovich, asking him to assign a Ukrainian priest to their parish. In their letter, they said, "We came here trustingly by ourselves, Excellency, but we were blind and naive. No longer are we the same people we were in our homeland because there is something lacking. We lack a God we could know and worship our own way. You, Excellency, are our Father here as well, because you are the Father of the Church of Ukraine. Even though we are from Western Ukraine and not from your diocese, we therefore ask you, provide us with spiritual fathers and give us your blessing to build churches so we may have here all that is sacred in Ukraine." In response to that request, a young priest, Father John Volansky, together with his wife, arrived in Shenandoah in 1884. After his arrival, the first task of the pioneer priest was to find a place to celebrate the liturgy. The Polish, German, and Irish pastors turned him down, so he rented Kern Hall in Shenandoah. And on Wednesday, December 18, 1884, on the second floor of that building, he celebrated the first Vesper service. In the corridor, he built a temporary altar, a simple decorated table, and kept it separate from the laity by a partition with three openings. There, on December 22, 1884, on the feast of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, according to the Julian calendar, the first Ukrainian liturgy was celebrated on the North American continent. Father Volansky earned a reputation as a tireless organizer and religious leader. In addition to fulfilling his religious duties, he oversaw construction of the first Ukrainian churches in America, traveling throughout the United States to minister to all Ukrainian immigrants. He came to Oliphant once in 1885 and then visited more often. Under his leadership, the Ukrainians in Oliphant initiated a church building fund in 1887. A year later, they erected a chapel which was dedicated to Saints Cyril and Methodius and eventually became one of the outstanding Ukrainian churches in America. The first pastor in Oliphant was Father Gabriel Wisłocki, not counting Father Volansky. Among the outstanding priests who worked in this city were Father Nicholas Strutinski, Father Michael Guriansky, who was the builder of St. John the Baptist Church in Detroit, Michigan, and Father John Ortinsky. From 1951 to this day, the pastor of Saints Cyril and Methodius Church in Oliphant has been mitered archpriest, Monsignor Stephen Prignuk. Now let us join the parishioners of Saints Cyril and Methodius and worship God in celebration of the Divine Liturgy. The Divine Liturgy of the Byzantine Rite of the Catholic Church is attributed to the 4th century Archbishop of Constantinople, John Chrysostom. It is used by both Eastern Catholic and Eastern Orthodox Christians. Before the public portion of the liturgy, the priest, in the rite of preparation called the proskomidia, prepares the bread and wine. The bread is leavened, unlike the unleavened flat hosts of the Western Church.
This rite takes place on a side altar and is done privately, thus representing the birth in Bethlehem and the hidden life of Jesus of Nazareth.
Oh.
liturgy begins as the priest opens the royal doors in the icon screen. These represent the gates of heaven, and the screen with its icons is seen as a connection between the heavenly realm and the earthly, just as Jesus himself was both human and divine. The first great incensation is now done by the priest of the altar, icons, and people of God, all of which are imbued with the divine presence of the Creator. After which the priest elevates the book while intoning, "Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever." The liturgy is being sung in Old Slavonic, which is the liturgical language of the ancient Slavs as developed by Saint Cyril, who together with his brother Saint Methodius are considered the apostles of the Slavs. A litany or series of petitions follows, to which we respond, Hospodi pomiloi, Lord, have mercy.
Держащего себя в воинстве, Господу помолимся. Ограді сам битлиці в жаком раді, весе живучене, Господу помолимся. Створений воздуху і зубили подовзних і временних мирних, Господу помолимся. Оплаваючи, потешествуючи, душа, страждаючи, пліненні, спасені, Господу помолимся. Ой, збавитися на всякі скорбі й нужди, Господу помолимся. Заступи, спаси, помилися нас, Боже, Твоєю благодатію. Пречатою причисти, приблагословений, славний лиш нашу Богородицю і Пресвятую Марію, со всіми святими помянувши самі себе і друг друга живот наш, Христу Богу предадим.
The first antiphon is now sung. We hear the beautiful words of the psalmist, Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. After this, the hymn Yedinorodni Sine, O only begotten Son, is sung. This underscores the early faith of the Church in Jesus as fully human and fully divine, immortal, yet being born in time for our sake.
Паки, паки, мир Господу, помолимся.
Господи, помилуй.
Заступи, спаси, помилися нас, Боже, Твоєю благодатію.
Господи, помилуй.
Пресвятую, пречистую, православною, славною, величну нашу Богородицю і пресвятую Марію, со всіми щедрими повинувши самі себе і друг друга животна, Христу Богу предаді. Яко благає чоловік, любить Бог, і сидиві славу зсилаєм, Отцу і Сину, і Святому Духу, нині пресно віки віков.
A small litany follows, and the second antiphon accompanies the movement of the little entrance. Here, the gospel book is brought in procession, which is said to suggest the beginning of the public ministry of Jesus. Day's liturgy.
When thou didst descend unto death, O life immortal, then didst thou vanquish hell with the splendor of thy divinity. When thou didst raise the dead from the subterranean abodes, all the powers of heaven cried, O life giver Christ our God, glory to thee. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Thou didst rise from the tomb, O Savior Almighty, and hell, seeing the miracle, feared, and the dead arose. Creation, also seeing this, exults with thee, and Adam rejoices, and the world, O my Savior, praises thee forever.
The ancient Trisagion is now sung. This text recalls the prophet Isaiah's text of the thrice holy exaltation of God. We exclaim, Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us. This explains another element of early Christian faith in God as triune, Father, Son, and Spirit.
Thank you.
now proclaim the epistle of the day.
Let us be attentive. Peace be tall. Wisdom be attentive.
My strength and my song is the Lord, who has been my salvation.
Wisdom.
Reading from the epistle of St. Paul to the Ephesians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, be strengthened in the Lord and in the might of his power. Put on God's armor, that you may be able to stand against the devil's wiles. For our fight is not against flesh and blood, but against the world rulers of this darkness, against the spiritual forces of the wickedness on high. Therefore, take up God's armor, that you may be able to resist on the evil day and stand perfect in all things. Stand, therefore, wearing the belt of truth and the breastplate of holiness, and with your feet shod in the readiness of the good news of peace. And in all things, take up the shield of faith, with which you will be able to put out all the flaming darts of the most wicked one. And take for yourselves the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is God's word.
During the singing of the Alleluia, another incensation takes place prior to the proclamation of the gospel.
Ще та Євангелія мирищі. At that time, Mary said, My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked upon his lowly handmaid, and henceforth all generations will call me blessed. For the Almighty has done wonders for me, and his name is holy.
Another small litany is now sung. This is followed by the hymn Ige Cherovimi.
Господи,
всевержи дню Божий, тиші наших, молимся, услыши і помилуй.
Господи, помилуй.
Помилуй нас, Боже, плечі милосердні, молимся, услыши і помилуй.
Господи,
Дійшим Вселенським, архірі нашим, Яні Павлі Покрістім, обернійшим верхом піспі нашим, слави Яні, опричащеншим піспі митрополиті нашим Степані, голові піспі нашим Володимирі, возлежавших и позивши храмі семючи наших духовних, всею речі, брати наше.
Господи,
помилуй.
Господи,
помилуй.
Господи, помилуй.
Державши власних наших і всем воїнстві.
Господи,
помилуй,
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Ще молимся, предстоящий Батия, милости от врящего милостыню и за все прославные христиане.
Господи,
помилуй.
Господи,
помилуй.
Господи, помилуй.
Любить Бог і Синові слави силаєм, Отцю і Сину, і Святому Духу, нині пресно віки віков.
Амінь.
Ділиться вірний, пахи ми Господу помолимся. Державою сохранимо тобі славу зілає, Отцю і Сину, і Святому Духу, нині пресно віки віков.
Let us, who mystically represent the cherubim and sing the thrice holy hymn to the life-creating Trinity, now set aside all earthly cares. Incensation occurs in preparation for the great entrance with the gifts of bread and wine, signifying Christ's triumphal entry into Jerusalem.
Thank you.
Christianity is wrong. Es ist ein bisschen 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 и во веки веков.
Аминь. Я куда стоящий под именем Бога.
Господу помолимся. О, избавитися на всякі скорбені в нужди, Господу помолимся. Сина ти у землі благословенісі, сопричетним вторящим твоїм духом, нині пресно віки віков. Возлюбим друг друга, да не мислим і збовіми.
Ancient symbol of faith is now recited. The priest holds the veil before his eyes, suggesting that the mystery about to take place, the transformation of bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ, requires the eyes of faith rather than the eyes of the body. Insight rather than sight is necessary.
The doors in wisdom, let us be attended.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not made of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and he became flesh, by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. He was also crucified for us, suffered under Pontius Pilate, and was buried. And on the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and of his kingdom there will be no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who together with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who spoke through the prophets. And one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I await the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In the Eucharistic prayer, or anaphora, we hear the words of Jesus himself. This is my body, this is my blood.
Дать Господь наш старобе Бога і Отця, і причастись до Духа буде сущими вами. Вопиюще, зивающе і лаголюще. Good. nova vita, я же забезна изливая моя, восставление грехов.
After the words of consecration, the body and blood of Christ are offered to the Father. Yours of your own, we offer to you on behalf of all and for all.
Твоя, твоїх, тебе приношаще усіх і завжди.
The Holy Spirit is invoked over the gifts. This ancient action is called the epiclesis. Sacred elements are now incensed as we honor the Mother of God in song. She is called more honorable than the cherubim and beyond compare more glorious than the seraphim. Another litany follows, and then the prayer of Jesus himself, the Our Father.
Архієре нашого на Папа Римського, блаженнійшого Верховіста Мирослава Йона, пресвященчого біспа митрополита нашого Стефана, і жедарища тим ти церквам річі вичизни за один свіжий, правоправяще слово Твоє істини. Серцем славити, вждівати пречесною великоліпі ім'я Твоє, Отця і Сина, Святого Духа, нині присно і во віки віков. І да будуть милости великого Бога і спаса нашої Христа со всіми вами.
Oh.
Чаще ти я повинувши паки, паки ми Господу помолимся. О, принесених чорчених зверів Господу помолимся. Дякую, Песні Божий, Духан Господи Божесний, благодать, і дальше та у Духа помолимся. Твої збавитися на всякі скорбені війну, де Господу помолимся. Заступи і спаси, помилися раз Боже, Твоєю благодатью. Днецю ж все намір грішного Господа просим. Ангела мирна, розсохни для душі тілес наших, Господа просим. Прощені, вистолені, гріхопрощені наші, Господа просим. Власне душа в нашій мера мир, Господа, просим. Прочі врем'я, щоб до нашого мир покияни скончати, Господа, просим. Християнське, кончити ж до нашого безболізне пустирне бирді до світа, Господа, просим. Свої денені віри, причастись до Духа, і списивши самі себе і друга живот наш, Христу Богу предадім. Подоби нас, владико, сидерзновенім, не осурнене швіти призивати тебе, небесного Бога і лагола ти. Яко Твої сарость, Твої сили, славу Отця і Сина і Святого Духа, нині і присно віки віков. Ви преклоніте. Благодати широте між одного сина Твого, з ним же благословен єси запріше ти мертворящим твоїм духом, нині і присно віки віков. Боже милостивий, Боже милостивий.
Both priest and people now prepare themselves for the reception of the body and blood of the Lord in Holy Communion. In the Byzantine Rite, the bread and wine are combined and are offered to the communicants on a small ritual spoon.
Страхом Божиєм і вірою приступіте.
I believe, O Lord, and confess that you are indeed the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Of your mystical supper, make me a partaker this day, O Son of God, for I will not speak of your mysteries to your enemies, nor like Judas will I give you a kiss, but like the thief will I confess to you. Remember me, O Lord, when you shall come into your kingdom. Remember me, O Master, when you shall come into your kingdom. Remember me, O Holy One, when you shall come into your kingdom. Not for judgment, nor for condemnation, be for me the partaking of these your holy mysteries, O Lord, but for the healing of my body and soul. O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God, cleanse my sins and have mercy on me. Innumerably have I sinned. Forgive me, O Lord.
Father among the saints, John Chrysostom teaches us, let no one come to Holy Communion with indifference, no one faint-hearted, but all with burning hearts, all fervent, all fully aware. Consider with what sort of honor you are honored, of what sort of table you are partaking, that which when angels behold they tremble and dare not so much as look up at it without awe, on account of the brightness that comes from the gift. With this we are fed, with this we are commingled, and we are made one body and one flesh with Christ.
Amen. Спаси Боже, люди Твоя, і благослови Твоя.
The people are blessed with the Holy Sacrament, which is then removed to the side table of preparation.
Це донині присно і во віки віков. Прости, приємніші, божесні, причисти, безсмертні, животворящі, страшні, рестолектай, достойно благодаримо Господа.
After a short litany, the final blessing and dismissal are given.
Спаси, помилися нас, Боже, Твоєю благодатію. Самі себе і друга живот наш Христу Богу придаді. Як ти священий наш, тобі славу силаєм, Отцу і Сину і Святому Духу нині присно і у віки віков. And sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people, bless your inheritance. Preserve the fullness of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power. And do not forsake with hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the priests, to our civil authorities, and to all your people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights, and he render glory to you, thanksgiving and worship to you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Преподобний бо насіч наших і всі святи помилуй і спасе нас, як облає чоловіка любе.
Are closed and the remaining Eucharistic elements are consumed by the priest and the vessels purified.
Lord,
Second Vatican Council teaches us, everyone knows with what love the Eastern Christians enact the sacred liturgy, especially the celebration of the Eucharist, which is the source of the Church's life and the pledge of future glory. In this celebration, the faithful, united with their bishop and endowed with an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, gain access to God the Father through the Son, the Word made flesh, who suffered and was glorified. And so, made partakers of the divine nature, they enter into communion with the Most Holy Trinity. Hence, through the celebration of the Eucharist of the Lord in each of these churches, the entire Church of God is built up and grows in stature.
Oh.